So after assessing the property, we realized disturbance frequency is one of your biggest issues in the turkey population and overall huntability of the turkeys. So when you talk about the last time you burned the CRP unit was 10 years ago and you burned it all at once, we're now going to advise that you break it up into a thirds, and we're going to burn every 3 years. So we're going to get you started on the first burn, and we're going to burn this little south part right here today. Winds out of the north. We're going to start here, and we advise always to kind of plan out, have a burn plan in place. And so typically we like to use backing fires and start on the downwind side for your fire. But in this case, the terrain lays north to south. So we know if we use that wind direction as a let's go and burn, start on the south side, we would start a head fire that was coming up the hill. We don't want to do that because the biggest part of our CRP is to the north. So because we have a north wind, we're going to start on this north side of the section. And because it's a north-south, north going to south burn unit. So we're going to start here, let it back down the slope.
We've got clear blue skies, which is a great fire condition. We've got, I would say, what, 5-8 mile an hour wind, something like that. Nothing too gusty, pretty consistent. And called the fire department. And so with this site fuel condition, I think we're ready to rock.
Sweet. Yeah, and that back fire break down there's got snow on it still. So.
That's
right. Right, it's on the north slope.
Keep it from going into the
Even if it jumped and went into the woods still have a lot of snow and wet, so we should be good to go. But let's not, I mean, knock on wood on that statement.
Yeah. But we got communication, so we'll stay in contact as we're branching out from this point and just start working it, black it in, and then let her go.
All right.
Y'all ready?
That's on shed number?
I say less than six.
I'm saying
one.
Hard number.
Okay, three.
I'm going five.
And
I'm bearing.
Going with one.
One shed in there.
Damn. You don't think he missed any?
Six.
Actually, there's going to be two right up here within 30 feet of this. Right here. That's it.
That's pretty
That's
bold.
All the
two and right here.
But you guys are going to go and you said you're going to blow around that persimmon to keep the fire
yes.
away from
yep.
it.
Yes. Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah. Like, we'll have fire around it, but we're going
to
start on the south side of it.
Gotcha.
With it's the wind.
It's not too hot and damage anything. We'll make
okay.
sure to
yeah.
protect it with the fire.
Nice.
You ready?
Ready.
Y'all
it's always
the fire department.
Sure did. Talked to a nice old gal. I don't know her name, but we talked. So we're standing right here on the starting point, ground zero, if you will. And we're going up the west line and the south line, kind of seeing which way the fire is going to react best, because we may continue south or we may keep going west. Right now, it seems like it's more intense on the south line, so we're going to keep going along this west line, east-west line, and lighten, letting it back down the hill.
So if you're a small private landowner like us and you're trying to find help to do this in
yes.
your area,
yeah, a cooperative is like a group of private landowners working together to manage a bigger piece.
Okay.
So if you have a bunch of neighbors and you form, let's say, 2,000 acres, there's grants in the state that you can apply, I think with Missouri Prescribed Fire Council, and get a trailer full of all this gear. Mm-hmm. And you can start burning on each other's properties and working together to for the better of the habitat. So
that makes sense. That went really well, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. About as good as you can imagine, anyhow.
So that's what you want. You want a light wind, consistent wind like that.
Yep.
Handful of guys, a drip torch, and that blower sure come in handy.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Having a blower or two on a fire line is a must. But the rakes are good, too.
What we're going to do now, we were just talking about this, since there's a bunch of this fescue crap underneath it, we're going to wait a month.
I like he's
so.
Already referred to it as crap with
yeah.
fescue.
I was referring to it as crap before.
Okay, good.
We haven't liked this stuff for a long time. We need to do the quail or the turkeys. But anyway, we burned it. It's mid-February right now. We'll probably wait a month, a little over a month, to see if that stuff starts sprouting out there. And then we're going to go back through it with some sort of herbicide, either glyphosate to try to kill it off or... You said maybe
yeah.
grass.
If it
selected.
Starts, if everything else starts growing, and you see some forbs or goldenrod stuff, we may back off and use a grass-specific herbicide just to kill the fescue.
Yeah.
So yeah.
So that's kind of the next step with that, just monitoring it for the next month and then going in there and spraying it. And yeah, went over real good.
Perfect.
Wasn't
so good. So good that we got a little bit ambitious, and now we're gonna burn another unit.
Let's do it. Set it a fire, boys.
It smells like somebody's barbecuing.